Hello everyone, welcome, welcome. My name is Kumar and this is a very, very special month. Not only is National Day, not only it's my birthday, but today is Nurses Day. All nurses, happy Nurses Day. I would like to thank all frontline nurses for their hard work. And let's celebrate this very special occasion. Because of COVID, guys, you know, right? We cannot have the normal kind of fun, the physical performance, the physical celebration. But this is not going to stop us from having fun, laughing and celebrating this very special day. There's a lot of things happening today, you know, ladies and gentlemen, in the show. We have a lot of special guests coming on. We're having a virtual fringe activities giveaway for NUHS nurses, including lucky draw, the air tickets to be given out. Because NUHS is a very big, incredible big family, you know. We have nurses from Cambridge campus, NUH, all the specialty centers, nursing school. We also have nurses from Jurong Health Campus, where you have the very new one, Ng Teng Fong General Hospital. The one that look like resort. Not forgetting our nurses from National University Polyclinics and Community Nurse. You want to know what's Community Nurse? That means the nurses who go to your house and treat the old people who are. Okay? And last but not least, of course, all the nurses from Alexandra Campus. Welcome, welcome, welcome everyone for this special Nurses Day event. I've got something to ask you. Why are nurses' uniforms so ugly? Why is it the color also not nice? And then they're all like A-line, they all wear pants. Why can't you all just wear a nice dress, a very sexy dress? Because some nurses have got very nice body, you know. Yeah. So she wear the nurse outfit, very short one, very sexy, you know, then in front the lower. Then some of them also quite nice. So you know, if you go to the hospital, you walk in when you're shift, right? You walk into the hospital, and a lot of old men will get discharged, you know. Man with dysfunction, confirm standing one. Man who got constipation, confirm let go already. All discharged. Then we have more beds in the hospital, won't complain, not enough bed. And some of the doctors are very, very good looking, you know. Just graduate one, I can tell from the face, and damn cute, you know, very fresh, just graduate like spring chicken. Wow, he opened the mouth, I got cured already, you know. Because he's so handsome. Some English, very, very good. Not the helicopter English, the very good English. And also got doctors who cannot dress up. Doctors, please make an effort to dress up because you are doctors. Some of you don't wear the stethoscope around your neck. People don't even know you're a doctor. No, they think you're working at the canteen. So please dress up. Do a bit of your hair. You're earning a lot of money, ma. Now someone cannot travel to New York, save the money. Give who? So today we have a lot of things happening. Firstly, what I'm going to do is, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to open the whole event with I'm going to have conversations, very interesting and fun conversation with a group of chief nurses. Are you ready? So ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for the first segment of today's event in conversation with all the some of the chief nurse? Professor Emily Ang, Group Chief Nurse for NUHS. If you still don't know what NUHS stands for, it stands for National University Health System. And then we have Ms. Joanne Pang, Chief Nurse of National University Hospital. Then we have Madam Kuttiyammal Sundarasan, our outgoing, she must be very outgoing, Chief Nurse of Jurong Health Campus. And we also have Ms. Ng Sao Chan, our incoming Chief Nurse of Jurong Health Campus, and Ms. Margaret Lee, Chief Nurse of Alexandra Hospital. And we have Jan C. Matthews of Chief Nurse of National University Polyclinic. Hello everyone, thank you very much for coming for this Zoom meeting. Are you all at work?
Yes.
Oh, okay, very good. You all work very hard, right?
Of course.
Okay, tell me, what is the most challenging during this whole pandemic?
Ever-changing policies.
Very good, very good, very good answer. Ever-changing policies. What about Kuttiyammal? What do you think?
We're just opening and closing wards to take in all the COVID patients, you know, because at Ng Teng Fong, we had the second largest number next to NCID.
Oh, Ng Teng Fong, you're Ng Teng Fong.
Yeah.
Your hospital look like holiday resort, right?
Yeah, correct.
How about your family? How do you all, like, after work, you have to go home and still be nice to your husband and your children, right? It must be quite hard also and challenging as well, right?
Always nice to husband.
That's a good one, Jancy. Always know how to separate work and family, which is very, very important. But I can never imagine me being a nurse. I think the most hardest job in the world is being a nurse. Because every day you go to hospital, you have to take care of sick people, you also see death. And then you got to go home and still smile and be happy with your husband and your children. It's very difficult for me because I'm very emotionally attached whatever I do. So I'll bring my emotions home. Now we have another question. I have a few questions. Which country you miss traveling now? Which country, if ever borders open, you want to go? The first country you want to go for holiday? Professor Emily?
Oh, I go holiday every year.
Of course, like, your salary is so high, ma.
When the border is open, I like to go to Turkey.
Istanbul, right? Talking about Istanbul, right?
Yeah.
A lot of good-looking men, huh?
I don't know. I haven't been there.
Huh? Oh, you want to go to Turkey, not that you've been there?
Yes.
Oh,
okay. I want to go when the border is open.
Okay, okay. But if I tell you something, if you go to Turkey, a lot of men, very, very handsome one. Okay, then we have another question. If you're not a nurse now, let's say you're not a nurse, what would the other job be? Do you have a dream job? If you're not a nurse, what else would you have done? Jancy?
I've only been a nurse and I don't think I will be anything else. So
you always wanted to be a nurse?
Yes.
Nice. What about Sao Chan?
A nurse is always a nurse.
No, but if let's say you're not smart like me, very stupid, cannot study one, cannot become nurse, then I become what?
I have never thought of a second one actually, yeah.
Wow, brilliant are you. Very good, very good. All of you, very good. Professor Emily, are you going to become a minister next?
No, how can I become a minister?
Why not? You already got the orchid ready, what? Your qualifications one tick ready. All of you vaccinated?
Yes.
Very good. I also vaccinated. Yes, yes. People are very nice at the vaccination center. Wow, they're extremely nice. I almost felt I wasn't even in Singapore. I think we are overly staffed at the vaccination center. I think we need to cut down our manpower. Even to show the exit sign, got people. Exit. And it's written there, exit. Like, see, we cannot read like that. Anyway, thank you very much. I want to ask you all... Do you think there's a lot, do you think this whole thing will end soon? This whole COVID? Or do we have to just live with it?
Very difficult question to answer.
I will tell you the answer, like, although I'm not a minister. I tell you, confirm very soon we have to live with it, like COVID is just another flu. Just take longer to recover. That's all. I'm telling you, we have to live with it. If not, we cannot go to a normal life already. Any special message from all of you on Nurses Day that you want to tell all your colleagues or other nurses? Let's start from Professor Emily. You give a message lah to all the nurses.
Okay, I'd like to thank them for all their hard work that they put through for the past 1 year, especially when at the height of the pandemic. Yep.
Very good. Thank you. Next one, Jancy.
I'd like to tell them that, you know, we've had a very, very challenging last 2 years, but they have stood the test and kudos to them for that. So keep the flag flying and
spread the love.
Wonderful, wonderful Nurses Day.
Thank you. Next we have Margaret.
Yeah, I'd like to thank every nurse for choosing to be a nurse and for sticking with us throughout all difficulties. And please know how proud we are of all of you. And please continue to turn to us and we are always here for you.
Yes, and Margaret, I also want to tell you something. You look too young to be a chief. You must...
I don't like that.
Okay, now we have Sao Chan.
Yeah, we want to thank all the nurses for responding to the crisis. And during this period, many jobs has changed. Even the nurses' work has changed. They get deployed to many areas. They get to move and respond to the change that is needed. And that really shows the resiliency of our nurses. And we are really proud of our nurses. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, nurses, for stepping up. Thank you.
And Madam Kutty?
Well, I really want to thank my nurses, really. This has been since last year, it's been very, very challenging. Honestly, I have gone through SARS. I think we came out of SARS quite okay. Mm. It's terrible. And my nurses, I really appreciate what they have done. They are so resilient. They're so hardworking. They go through so many changes. You know, my nurses almost like every other week, they have to change to a different ward. They have really shown that they love the work and they want to help the patients and they've done very well. So like to wish them a happy Nurses Day. And also because I'm outgoing, I want to wish my nurses all good luck. Stay positive, stay resilient, be happy, look after the patients, look after your family.
Oh, also, I also want to add on for the nurses is all the foreign worker, the nurses from Philippines, from India, from whichever country you are, it is also very challenging for you all. So thank you very much for your sacrifice, because you cannot even go back and see your own family. It must be very, very hard. So thank you for all your sacrifice. Totally appreciate it. Gratitude to the max.
You never give me a chance,
Kuma. Oh, yeah. You're supposed to talk my automatic, ma. You see, take turn.
No, ma. Everybody call name, but you never call my name.
Joanne. Ah, okay, Joanne, your turn, Joanne.
I just want to say a big thank you to our nurses. They are really angels in scrubs. In times of pandemic, they really stood up to the challenge, and we are really proud of them. Happy Nurses Day to them.
So you want to ask me any question, also I can answer you, not as a minister, but I can just answer you like anything fairly.
Yes, I start first.
Can?
If you have something to cheer our nurses on this happy occasion, what would you say?
I think this happy occasion, I think it's already very good, because first time on Nurses Day, the nurse are not performing. It's already a very, very beautiful thing. I think what they should do for nurses is send them for spa treatment. You know, give them free spa treatment, and not the spa people do for them. The patients do for them, because you always do for the other way around, ma. Because you always take care of the patient. Now the patient must take care of you. Then they know how tough it is to take care of. Some patients are very, very difficult also. So I think that's what they should do for all nurses in Singapore.
Kuma, can I ask you?
Yes, Jensi.
Have you ever thought of being a nurse?
No. Never. I cannot see death. I cannot see death. I get very emotionally affected. So I rather not go there. Lah. That's why I say your job is the most hardest job. Yeah. Any more question?
Ma,
yes, Kuti. Wait. Joanne, wait. Lah. She put up hand ready. Ayo.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. Yes, Kuti.
It's not a question, but I want to ask you, do you remember that my very first Nurses Day as a chief nurse started with you?
Wow. Alexandra Hospital, is it?
Yes.
Yeah. I was performing behind the mortuary. Perfect place to perform for an Indian.
Incidentally, it's my last Nurses Day as a CN. Going on to do another role.
Well done. You will definitely do well in that. Trust me, I know. Indians, we work very hard and we are very passionate about what we do. Joanne.
Yes, Kuma, I can talk.
Yes, you can.
I wanted to ask you, at the peak of pandemic, just before we sort of closed the border, were you one of those that rushed to Sheng Siong to buy toilet paper?
No, because I'm Indian, we don't use toilet paper.
Serious?
It's true, what?
Is that true?
We like our behind to be very clean. Not with leftover, something hanging in the Uranus, all we don't like. But it's the Chinese are the most kiasu, kiasi, don't know, kiam, whatever. Run and buy. You all but rush and buy toilet paper, never mind. Instant noodle some more. Instant noodle is so unhealthy, eh? Right, not? You eat so much instant noodle, next time you wake up, your hair still in bed. All the hair drop already. Any other question you want to ask me? If not, we will finish this, because you all got to go back to work already.
Kuma, I want to ask you one question.
Yes, Professor Emily, MP for Orchid.
What do you do in pandemic when you cannot do your show?
I stay at home and pull hair. Every hair also I pull. No lah. I cannot do show. I just got used to it. I stay at home. I got two dogs, ma. My dogs are my life. I talk to them. I talk to them so much during the whole circuit breaker. Now I open my mouth and they two walk and go and hide under the dining table. They want me to talk already. Because I talk a lot to them and spend more time. Because I think during this, COVID has also been an enemy and also helped a lot of family to come together more, bonding, understand your wife, your children, your parents. Everyone was working. We always thought work as an escape. Now you cannot escape. So you're forced to be with your family, spend the whole year work from home, how to handle stress, and how to keep your mental health good. We have learned all that now, so everyone can actually slow down a bit. So this is a wake-up call, and the whole COVID is now time set. Reset your whole time and start your life all over again, which is a brilliant thing. I love it. So anyway, thank you very much, all nurses, chief nurses, and hope to not see all again. Because if I come to your hospital, that means not good reason. Okay, so thank you very much. I will see you all sometime soon. Happy Nurses Day.
Thank you. Nurses Day, thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, on this lovely Nurses Day, 1st August, all nurses be happy. Our next segment is we're going to bring in a very beautiful internet personality, and she's a singer. So let's welcome Annette Lee from the Lee family. Hey, sorry, Lee family only got one girl.
But you never know, maybe we're related. Because a lot of Lees then.
So all the Lees are related.
Maybe.
Then the Bengali also Lee. Okay, never mind. So you're going to sing a lovely song called Brave, right?
Yes.
Okay, tell us about the song.
So this is a song by Sarah Bareilles.
Sarah Bareilles is not a country, it's not a state. It's the name of an Ang Mo girl.
But I might not mind travelling to a place called Bareilles.
I don't mind travelling into Bareilles.
Okay, anyway, I'm going to be singing this song called Brave by Sarah Bareilles. But I changed the lyrics up quite a bit. I reimagined it to be a song that's perfect for the nurses today.
You wrote it?
No, I didn't write it. I just rewrote the lyrics.
You rewrote the lyrics.
So that, you know,
so it's, you're not just a singer, nice, you're a smart singer. You can write your own lyrics.
Yes. I'm also not just a singer. Yeah. I'm also an internet personality. And I make a lot of videos. And
you know, when you're popular, you don't show off. Doesn't work. Never
no,
show off.
No, because I need to share with you about my friend who's always... No, because okay. I want to tell you about my friend who's always in my videos with me. Oh, and she's coming later. So I need to say...
Okay. Yeah. So you got a friend coming later.
Yes, she's always in my videos. So I need to talk about how
you're
in my videos.
Maybe you're a ventriloquist. Your hand is up.
Oh, really? She's my friend.
Okay, she's your friend. So later we will meet her friend, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
But for now, let's get Annette Lee to sing her lovely song, Brave.
Nurses, you're amazing. You make us believe in the hope to pull to life. Nurses, you're the heroes. You're the pillars. You go the extra mile for us. Oh, you just shine like stars. Nurses, when you hold us, some kind of magic flows through your fingertips. You bring in the sunlight from the outside. No fear will ever win. So we wanna shower you with love and say what we wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, we wanna tell you you're brave. Just what we wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, your courage is first rate. Just wanna tell you, we just wanna tell. Just wanna tell you, we wanna tell you you're brave. Suited up, masked up, you've gone through much and you're always there for us. When no one else can be there, nurses, you are like family to us. Chin up, we're cheering you on. Let us all raise a toast, you have fought the good fight. You have gone beyond your call. Great is your sacrifice. We'll show you how much we love you. We'll say what we want to say and let the words fall out. Honestly, we want to tell you you're brave. That's what we want to say. We'll let the words fall out.
Thank you for doing what you do every day for our patients and their families.
Thank you for making a difference to our patients.
Thank you very much for all the hard work that you've put in to take care of our patients.
Hugs and kisses to all our nurses.
Never forget how amazing and privileged we are to be nurses.
We appreciate you for the work that you do every day and for the many unspoken sacrifices you have made.
You are the heart of our hospital. It is your professionalism and care that make all the difference to our patients.
You are the angels who nurse our patients back to health.
The kindest and most authentic people on earth.
You are the backbone, the face, and the heart of a truly incredible health system.
We appreciate the unmatched sense of responsibility and dedication.
I appreciate you and celebrate you today and every day.
Thank you for everything you do for us.
Thank you for your dedication.
Thank you and happy Nurses Day.
Keep up the good work. Stay safe and well.
I would like to say a big thank you. Happy Nurses Day.
Say what we wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, we wanna tell you you're brave. What we wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, your courage is first rate.
Just wanna thank you. Just wanna thank you. Just wanna tell you.
Thank you, Annette, with the lovely song, Brave. I hope all nurses watching this has made your day. This song is really, really beautiful. And she'll be back soon with her friend, Chantel. And also, I'd like to thank all the senior management for all their wonderful recorded messages. Thank you very much. And also, I'd like to thank Professor Yao Kewan, Chief Executive of NUHS, and Mr. Xia Fu Hua, Chairman of NUHS Board. Now, I'm going to ask you some questions. Before that, I tell you, you all sang well and you all performed well. Very good. You all volunteered, I heard. Good karma on you, doing something for the nurses. First question, what do you think nurses misses the most? What do you think the nurse miss the most?
I think having a break, maybe having a vacation.
Ah, having a vacation. Good, good. Where do you think they like to go? Back home?
Home. I think many of them haven't gone home for...
almost going to be 2 years.
A year. Yeah, more than a year.
You?
Yeah, time with the family, for sure.
Time with the family, yeah? Very good, very good, very good. So, you got any message for the nurses?
Well, I just want to thank all our nurses for their fabulous care for our patients. Say thank you and happy Nurses Day.
And you, sir?
Well, I would say all of you have actually made these 2 years for me extremely memorable in how you've served all our patients and given your full energy and commitment. So, thank you all.
Yes, because it's a very challenging year. It's been very, very challenging. Do you have any interesting NUH nurse encounter? Have the nurses flirted with you? Never. So boring in life.
So when I was a junior doctor and it was in my first month, I was in the intensive care unit, and there were three senior nursing sisters that taught me everything and made sure everything was done correctly. So it was Sister Gek Chu, Sister Bing, and Sister Bi Ling. If you're out there listening to this, I'm forever grateful and thank you so much for the mentorship and at that time. Thanks.
Thank you, nurses. When he says sister, not like me, sister. A real sister, a real woman. They call them sister. Thank you, sir. And you?
I would like to share this very memorable encounter I had about... Now, at the start of the COVID, actually. And, you know, I was talking to this nurse of mine and colleague of mine and I said, are you afraid? Because, you know, she's got young children, two young children, very young children. And she said, no. Huh? I said, how come? And she said, that's because we have all been well prepared. Oh. So we are confident in each other.
Yes.
That's what she said. I thought that was extremely memorable.
Yeah, you know? And very motivating
too. And very motivating.
Yes, brilliant. Whoever the nurse is talking about, well done, good on you. Okay, so thank you very much, Professor. And thank you very much, Chairman, for your participation. Thank you for coming all the way down to give this lovely interview. We're going to bring on the next segment already. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, and just now the two guys who came, Mr. Kewan and Mr. Fu Hua, I want to tell you something about them. They are so kind, but they're very humble because they don't want me to announce the surprise in front of them. So, I'm going to tell you now. There's going to be one lucky winner from the lucky draw who's going to walk away with a pair of two tickets sponsored by the two men. Yes. To any of your chosen country, these countries you can choose London, Zurich or Paris. On top of that, they also donated $2,000 for your spending money. How brilliant is that? So sweet of them. I knew they're nice people. Okay, clap, 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 clap. But don't worry, if you did not get the grand prize, NUHS, National University Health System is giving out a bonus prize sponsored by Qatar Airways, a pair of air tickets to any of their European destination. They also have other lucky draw like 50 tote bags from Qatar and toasters. Coasters. Sorry, not toaster. Coasters. That is the bonus lucky draw.
Wow, can I also win?
To give you more details about other things that you can do, let's move to this Chinese girl, Chantel.
Chantel, her name. Hi.
Yes. Hi. Give the IG info.
So, you know, I'm an influencer. You're not going to ask me who I am? No, I'm not sick.
You are a sick, maybe you're buying.
I know it's Nurses Day, but you know, it's not to be
confused with the
not
influenza.
Confused. I almost think of the flus, so I say confused.
You said confluse, it's okay with your English. I'm also very confused, loose.
Yeah, so you know, have you been vaccinated? I want to ask you.
Of course, it's my age group done already, darling.
Actually, yeah, you look very old. So, you know, I haven't been vaccinated, but I'm going to be
Rewind. Did you just say I look very old? Excuse me, you know, after all the swallowing I've done. Okay, carry on.
I'm still waiting to be vaccinated so that I can travel because, you know, I'm a travel influencer. So,
they should even never let you travel. They should lock you up and throw the key.
Anyways, you know, if you like me and you want to travel, but you cannot travel yet, then I can bring the travels to you because we have this NUHS special Instagram filters. Do you have Instagram?
Yes.
Why you never follow me?
Because I don't like you. I don't even know you exist, my dear. Because
you know
we all old people only Facebook.
I probably have more followers than you.
Of course you have. I have the whole SPCA following me.
Okay, so anyways, so you just download the filter that, you know, there's a code on the screen, so you can download it. And you know, it looks like this. You see?
Wow, I can see there's Paris.
Francis, and no, this is the Japan.
Korea. Hey, Japan. Japan also got cherry blossom.
Japan is the one that's Sakura, not Korea.
Oh, no, Korea. Okay.
There's a Korea one also.
Wow.
I don't know how to say it.
They should have done one IG, like inside the hospital. Or they should have done one like inside Lee Kuan Yew house.
But that's not traveling, that's in Singapore.
Going to his house is a travel, trust me. It's a scary travel.
Before?
No, I've never. Nobody can go inside.
Oh, I see. Well, you know, if you want to travel outside Singapore, then you can download
use all
the filter.
This IG, and please remember you can download, but don't overdo it because you can go cuckoo because it's an addiction.
Also, there's this special NUHS Nurses Day sticker pack. You know, you can use it on your WhatsApps or your Telegram. All you have to do is download the sticker pack. You know, you can scan this QR code here and then you download the apps and then you add it to your WhatsApp. See, like this. It's not stickers.
Oh, stickers.
It's cute stickers, not.
So, you can download all these. You can play with your own IG filters. And you can, nurses, you can also have your own GIFs. Which is really, really nice. You have the grand lucky draw. That's the sponsored by the lovely two men. And then you have a bonus prize sponsored by Qatar Airways. Two tickets to any of their European destination. And you can also get the 50 tote bags from Qatar Airways with coasters as well. All this only for nurses from NUHS. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, have a great time. Thank you so much for tuning in, watching me and watching this thing trying to speak
Chantel,
good English.
Yeah, thank you.
This Chantel time. Thank you. Yes. Okay, so have a great Nurses Day. Love y'all.